Hola mis amigos and possible amigas, my name is Taffrey16, welcome back to Reading Your Comments. I had to upload that reaction video early so I could get this out at normal time, and I don't know if I ever uploaded a reaction video and a Reading Your Comments video on the same day, but first time for everything, let's read some comments. More Doctor Who, please Taff, enjoying the journey, episode 3 if you can, my dude. Yeah, I'm going to be doing it. Rob put, I believe, episodes 3, 4, and 5 in the drive folder the other day, so I can tell you right now that we'll definitely be doing more, especially since I've gotten such a positive response to doing more. So yeah, we'll definitely be doing more at some point here. You have better understanding of Brexit than you think. What, that is a complete clusterfuck? Fair enough. I love how these videos have better video quality than PewDiePie's. Well, I have a 4K webcam. That's how. I'm recording this right now using my webcam app. If he buys a 4K webcam, he can have that too, and I'm sure he can probably afford it. I wonder, are there any reaction videos made by British people to American shows? Yeah, that's a good question. I've never looked, and I honestly don't know. I feel like British people maybe don't enjoy our shows as much as we enjoy their shows. You know, is that a fair assessment? I don't know. But I mean, it seems like a lot of, whenever I get negative comments, it's that my humor's shit or I don't understand their humor. And that's mainly because our humor is different. So I wouldn't imagine British people would enjoy a lot of American shows. But I enjoy a lot of British shows, so. Still think you should react to Art Attack. I think it was CITV. I don't even know what that is, but I'll look into it. And it better be about people attacking other people with art. Just brutal art wars. Just like, hey, you like this art? Oh, I do like that art. Wham! A new Vicar of Dibley is called for. Possibly. I wouldn't be against watching more of it. Right now, the only sequels I'm really focused on are Inbetweeners and Doctor Who. The main goal is to do new stuff. I don't want to just clutter it up with a bunch of sequels. But again, there's certain programs I'm open to doing sequels of in the future. You know, Red Dwarf, Taskmaster, Shooting Stars. I said Vicar again, didn't I? Vicar of Dibley. Vicar, goddammit. But yeah, it's on my list for maybe something to do down the line. The prequel to Only Fools and Horses was called Rockin' Ships. Yeah, but that's not what I was talking about. I guess I was wrong. It wasn't actually a prequel. It was a show called Lucky Feller. And basically, it was seen as kind of a dry run for Only Fools and Horses. Like, it didn't actually have anything to do with the show, but like the basic setup of the show. It was like it didn't last long. It only lasted like 8 episodes. But the basic setup of the show was seen as like the premise of or origins or whatever for Only Fools and Horses, even though it didn't actually have anything to do with one another. But yeah, it was kind of seemed like a dry run. And I downloaded an episode of that, so maybe we'll check it out in the future. Stupid Article 13, time to get a VPN. Yeah, I mean, if it ends up being exactly what we think it is, that might be what you have to do. But again, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Yes, Horrible History is the most historically accurate children's show ever made. From what I remember, Fort Boyard was on Channel 4 or 5. Channel 5? Oh, God. That's a whole new thing to dive into. I didn't even know there was a Channel 5. I know Channel 4 doesn't like me. How does Channel 5 feel? Shit. Oh, crap. Why didn't somebody tell me about Channel 5? Fuck. Anyway, Horrible Histories. Yeah, Rob got me an episode of it, so I'll be doing it at some point here, probably in the near future. That kind of reminds me of a show. It's not a kid show we have here. We have a show here called Drunk History. And apparently, actually, they made a UK version in 2015. I don't know if it was any good or better. But it's, if you haven't seen it, either version, it's basically a show about celebrities who get drunk and try to recite history to the best of their abilities. And it's pretty fucking funny. Where's Kitty? We want Kitty. No Kitty is like Batman with no Robin. Good to know I'm Batman, but hey, don't look at me. She was here earlier. I don't know where she went. The Mighty Boosh, BBC. Vimeo it is then. I will look into it, but yeah, if it's BBC, it's a 95% chance it's going to be Vimeo. Pointless reacting to more Doctor Who since it's on now and you can watch it on BBC America. The whole point is to react to comedy shows from the past, I thought. No. Well, again, by that logic, there's no point in me reacting to more Inbetweeners because I can just find all the episodes on YouTube. By that logic, there's no point in me doing any more Inbetweeners either. And the whole point is to watch comedy shows from the past? No. The whole point is for me to watch shit I haven't seen before. I didn't even start with comedy shows. I started with children's shows and then went into commercials and then went into... Fuck, what was after that? Top Gear and shit. I don't even remember the first comedy show I did, but yeah, that's not the point. Noah, out of curiosity, what current TV shows are you watching at the moment? Excited for Game of Thrones? Never seen Game of Thrones, actually. And believe it or not, I really don't watch any TV at all. I don't have cable TV here. I canceled it like 5 years ago. I don't watch television at all. In fact, what's funny, we have Netflix. I don't really watch that either. The only television show I watch, I haven't even watched. Like, what I mean by that is the only television show I watch is Better Call Saul, which is the prequel to Breaking Bad. And they recently came out with their fourth season. It was 10 episodes, and I watched the first episode, and I still haven't gotten caught up. I haven't watched the next 9. So yeah, even the show I technically watch, I don't watch. In fact, the only time I really watch TV is either when I'm watching a sports game or when I'm reacting to a TV show in these videos. Noah, I've been trying to call you for weeks now. I hate to make this public, but it's the only way I can get your attention. A few months ago, at the Let's All Be Sexy and Hook Up Orgy event, you got pregnant and we ran off from the group, remember? No. But anyways, I don't want anything. I just want you to meet your child. And she was born. Yes, we're having a baby daughter. I think I'm going to name her Roof. So I can have a little baby Roof. So please get back to me, thanks. Blade, the only thing you're getting back from me is a restraining order. Whatever you do, don't watch the American version of Taskmaster. They absolutely ruined it. You know what's funny? I looked up the American version. It came out, I think, in last year, actually, on Comedy Central. And it was really, really weird because it only ran for 8 episodes. And it only ran for not even a month, like just a total of about 3 weeks. Because what they did is they premiered 2 episodes a day. So they premiered episodes 1 and 2 on the same date, and 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. And then it ended in 3 weeks, and then they announced there wouldn't be a second season. So, yeah, I imagine it didn't go very well. What did you think A Christmas Cracker was? I imagined it was just a white guy who enjoyed the holidays. Just if you don't know, Alex Horn doesn't normally wear those earrings. He just looks a bit different for each episode for a joke. Oh, I got you, because, Jesus, I mean, I'm not against anybody getting gauges, but, like, they stretch your ears out so fuck. I imagine if you get gauges, your ears, like, your earlobes never permanently close ever again. Like, that's a big decision to make. How did you not notice Phil Wang's Kill Bill suit really shows off how tiny his penis is? Because I wasn't looking there, Lucy. But apparently somebody was. Naughty, naughty, naughty. Phil is dressed like Bruce Lee in Game of Death. Ah, okay. I think I've seen Game of Death like once, but I've seen Kill Bill a bunch of times. But I definitely see what you're talking about. It's definitely originated there, but I'm pretty sure also that's where Tarantino got the inspiration for the Kill Bill outfit. For the last 2 months, I've been watching you react to shows I've never seen before. Not complain, just a bit strange. Yeah, I know what you mean, but hey, I mean, it doesn't have to be just me that sees stuff I've never seen before. Maybe you guys can see some stuff you've never seen before as well. It's kind of a cool way to look at it. Never seen that before. Wow, it sucked. Well, thank you for your positive contribution. Man, I'd take Rick Ashley, Never Gonna Give You Up over Theresa May and Brexit any day. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Damn it, I wanted the full song. I was just getting into it. You know what's funny? The original version of that April Fool's video did have the full song. But when I uploaded it like that, because I put the full song in there, it got blocked worldwide. But then I edited it and only used like 50 seconds of the song, and then it was good to go. I was expecting something daft, but I'd forgotten Rick. Oh no, that tune's gonna be in my head for another decade. Well, I mean, it's not like you ever have to hear it again. Have I just been Rick-rolled on April Fool's Day in 2019? Fucking genius. You have so been saving this for weeks, I bet. Believe it or not, no. I had been saving the Far Cry video for weeks because I knew of that Easter egg where you could beat the game in like 20 minutes. But literally, I was in the shower and I was thinking, maybe there's another fucking April Fool's video I can do. I'm like, maybe I could Rickroll somebody. I don't know. And then literally after I got in the shower, I was drying someone off. drying myself off. Don't read into that. Drying myself off. I was like, Jesus Christ. When I was drying myself off, I was thinking, what would be a good title for that? Like, I didn't think it would be something that I would never actually do but could catch attention. I was like, Brexit. And I literally just like fucking bolted to my computer and went and made that. And I do not regret it at all. Ashley for Prime Minister. I mean, that's not a bad idea. I mean, after all, he's never going to give you up. He's never going to let you down. He'd never just, you know, run around and desert you. I mean, he seems like a good guy to have. I mean, he's, you know, never going to make you cry. He's never going to say goodbye. He's never going to run around and hurt you. So yeah, I'd vote for him too. All right, y'all. Well, that's going to do it for another episode of Reading Your Comments. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Pure usual. Pure usual. Sure. Pure usual. You can see. If you want to get your comment read for next week, just put, yeah, fuck. Just comment down below in the comment section. That wasn't hard, was it? Just comment down below in the comment section or on probably the two reaction videos in between this video and next one. Your comments is probably where I will pull the comments for the next reaction video. And that's a fucking mouthful. Only it's not. I'm just terrible at speaking, apparently. But that is going to do it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked it, be sure to like it. If you didn't like it, don't. If you want to follow any of my social media links, my Twitch, where I stream every single day, my second channel, Free Steam Reviews, my Twitter, if you want to follow me, my Patreon, if you want to support me, or my Vimeo, where you can see all the videos that have been blocked from YouTube. Literally just uploaded a reaction to there today, which was the Inbetweeners number 7. All those are in the description. Also in the description is a link to my schedule where you can see what's gonna be posted on the channel every single day. But with that being said, my name is Taffer16. This has been another episode of Reading Your Comments. I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.
Hello, are you my family?
You don't have a family, and we're all going to die. I still see a shadow.